Investors appear to be buying the dip on quantum computing. Is now a good time to get in on this speculative industry? Here to share three stock picks in quantum computing that aren't Rigetti is MarketBeat analyst Chris Markoch. Chris, we talked about quantum computing on our channel last week, talking about Rigetti, which is a leader in quantum computing, something a lot of investors are excited about right now. These stocks have seen quite a rise really rapidly, Chris.
They really have. And one of the things that I noticed when I was writing my article was all three of the stocks we're going to talk about today have shown the exact same pattern. They shot higher late in the year, tailed off significantly since the start of the year, but in the last week or so, they're starting to come back.
There is definitely a comeback happening right now. And we'll look at those stock charts in just a minute as you share your picks. How did you narrow down your list?
I was paying attention to what NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang brought up last week when he was saying that quantum computing was still years or decades off at scale. So I was thinking, okay, well, what's the opportunity here for investors? And so I was looking for companies that offered incremental opportunity in quantum computing today that could be profitable the next few years before the technology actually got done at scale. And that's a theme that I think you'll see through each of these three picks.
There are lots of people who are saying that quantum computing is maybe still a couple of decades away from being fully scalable and commercialized. Right. But growth investors are usually okay with that kind of wait as long as there's a big payoff in the long run. There is a free premium report with seven stocks just like that right now. It's seven stocks that could be bigger than Tesla and NVIDIA and Google. Scan the QR code or click the link in the description to get that free report right now on MarketBeat.com. All right, Chris, let's get to your first stock pick in quantum computing stocks that aren't Rigetti. This one is interesting for a lot of reasons.
Sure. So the first pick is IonQ, and the ticker symbol is IONQ. So we were just talking, Bridget, we said, what's a reason why quantum computing may be years or decades away? Well, one reason is these computers require a sub-zero temperature environment to operate just because of the massive amount of energy that they require to do these high-speed calculations. That's where IonQ may have a competitive advantage. Right now, they're designing quantum computers that can operate at room temperature. If it can begin delivering those computers at any scale, that's a huge competitive advantage in the sector. To help them with that process, they've got a $54.5 million contract with the U.S. Air Force, and they've also got a partnership with AstraZeneca, which is significant because one area where quantum computing is expected to have the most impact is in the area of drug discovery.
So those contracts are very exciting, Chris, but that doesn't necessarily mean profitability quite yet.
IonQ, as well as the other two companies that we're going to be talking about today, are not profitable yet, but the contracts are significant because that's how they're going to be generating revenue, which also could prevent them from having to do things such as share offerings, which would be dilutive to shareholders.
Well, let's take a look at the chart really quick for IonQ. What has the stock been doing?
In the last week or so, it's climbed above what this blue line here is, the 10-day moving average. If you're a trader, that's a signal to you that there's interest in the stock and there might be momentum building. The stock is climbing significantly above that 10-day moving average, so there might be a little bit more of a run coming here.
Very good. Yep. Is the same thing true for your next stock pick?
Yeah, because again, what we've said is these stocks are showing a remarkably similar pattern. And the next stock that we want to talk about is Arquit Quantum. Ticker symbol is ARQQ. This one I found interesting because instead of developing quantum computers per se, what they're doing is they're attempting to defend against them. Quantum computers can do all this processing very fast. They would have the potential to break through traditional encryption methods. And that could be a threat for cybersecurity companies. Arquit comes in, they're helping to protect high security data, even through VPNs, with a cloud-based encryption subscription service that is supposedly quantum proof. So that was where I thought was really interesting in this, is that they're already looking at what the potential threat is and how to defend against that threat.
Yeah, very interesting concept. It is. and different than IonQ quite a bit. Right. But I think it's very forward thinking when you're building new technology to right away think about how are we going to be able to defend against this new technology as well.
Yeah, it's almost scary when you think about it.
Absolutely. Anything about this stock chart that stands out, or does it look just like IonQ?
It looks almost exactly like IonQ, which was a fascinating thing. It peaked around December 31st, dropped significantly, but you've been seeing it climb in the last week or so. And again, it's climbed above that critical moving average stage.
Well, let's get to the third pick, which again, when we see this stock chart, going to look very similar.
So the company is D-Wave. Ticker symbol here is QBTS. So investors can think of the word qubits if they want to think about this. There's two ways that people can do quantum computing. One is called gate-based, and the other one is using annealing technology, and that's what D-Wave uses. As simply as I can put it, what annealing technology does is it analyzes these little bits of matter called qubits, and it tries to find its optimal state or ground state where it will be at its most stable, and it can therefore perform the calculations fast. If you're looking through a haystack of data, annealing technology goes in and tries to find the needles that you need that are going to help get you processing that data even faster than you could currently do it. So it's an interesting play on quantum technology. And right now, D-Wave is the leader in that segment.
We've had several people comment about D-Wave. It's a stock in quantum computing that several people are invested in, but it's still one of the lower entry points to get into.
Yeah, this was a penny stock, literally a penny stock. It's up above $6 now, and it's showing the same pattern, though. It broke above its 10-day moving average. Right now, it's trading at around $6.57, possibly has room to challenge that $10 mark where it was late last year. Investors, again, want to be careful. These are going to be volatile stocks. Because it's broken above that moving average, there might be an opportunity here.
Very interesting. All of these stocks, very interesting and different concepts than maybe general investors are used to hearing about, kind of hard to understand. How does an investor choose which one to invest in?
The good news is that all three of these stocks are priced in such a way that you could invest in all of them with a fairly nominal amount of money. Another option would be to look for ETFs. The risk there is that you're buying the trash along with the treasure, so you have to be a little bit more careful there. With this sector, is you're going to have conviction, because the ultimate payoff is still several years away. You don't have to commit all of your money to it right now. You don't have to go all in on these, but they're priced in such a way that you can buy a little now and continue to add as you go along.
What should investors expect to see with these kind of speculative buys, especially in a sector that's getting so much attention and even from the trading community?
You're going to see volatility in this sector. It's what you should expect. I think ultimately the payoff is going to be big, but the actual payoff is still several years away, and there's going to be ups and downs on our way to get there.
Well, I do think there are plenty of investors out there that are looking for exactly this, something with a big payoff, even if they have to wait a little bit. Thank you, Chris, very much for giving us an introduction to these three different stocks in quantum computing that aren't Rigetti. You can check out our last video on Rigetti if you're interested in learning more about that stock too. Thanks again for watching us here on MarketBeat. As always, happy investing.